everybody, it's Patricia and welcome back to my channel. And it's time to do my empties for October. And I have quite a few. Well, it may look like I have quite a few because I have candles. And I see that I'm going through candles quickly. I burn way more candles in the fall and winter than I do in the spring and summer. So I might need to make another trip to Bath & Body Works, even though I said I was done. But I might need candles. Or I might get them from Yankee Candle. Or I might get them from somewhere else. I don't know. But I need candles. So let's get started. First, this was one I bought just a few weeks ago. This is Frozen Lake. This says White Barn. Our Bath & Body Works in our mall has two big stores side by side. And one is all the Bath & Body Works stuff. And you can go between the two from the inside. And the other side is White Barn with candles. And that's where I got this from. So, this smells so good. At first, I thought it was giving me a headache. And then I realized it's the new medication I'm on that's giving me the headache. It wasn't the candle. I almost gave this away to my mother-in-law, and I'm glad I didn't. And I love this jar. I am totally going to recycle this jar. Let's see, what is the notes in this? Lavender leaves, cool eucalyptus, juniper berries with essential oils. I liked it. I liked it a lot. Love the jar. I will be repurposing that jar, and it will be on my vanity to hold something. Next, I used another one. This smells so good. This is the first time I've seen this one. Salted butterscotch. It smells just like butterscotch. Warm brown sugar, sweet cream, pinch of sea salt, melted butter with essential oils. That's how you make butterscotch. That smells yummy. It made me hungry. These kind of scents make me hungry when I burn them. But it was so good. It was so good. I would buy another butterscotch. I think I would stock up on butterscotches. Those smell good. Now, I have a couple Yankee candles, and I picked these up when I was in Myrtle Beach on vacation in, when did we go? September. And I've already burned them. But these were smaller ones. This is oak and amber incense. Love this. This is my type of scent. In the winter, I like those woodsy scents, and especially if they're smoky woodsy scents. They're my favorite. Also, around Christmas, I love the smell of like pine or balsam. Those are my favorite. So, does this tell me what it smells like? No, they don't do like Bath & Body Works does. So, it's oak and amber incense. Gosh, that smells so good. It almost smells like a men's cologne, if you are interested. But I love it. And then this one was pumpkin apple parfait. And I'm sorry, I don't burn mine correctly. It's, yeah, it is what it is. So this one smelled just like pumpkin apple pie. It was good. Yeah, and this made me hungry. Like I said, these kind of scents make me hungry. So there we go. I burned those four candles. I used a hand soap, Margarita Time from Bath & Body Works. And now all of my sinks have got the appropriate fall, winter soaps. I believe they all do. Yeah, I think they all do. I don't know about my son. I can't remember. He's funny anyway. I mean, he's very particular. Oh, got another. Well, here's another one. Kitchen Lemon. That one I used up. And another bath and shower gels. Melon Daiquiri. From Philosophy. This smelled really good. Yeah. That smells really, really good. Use that up. Now, I used up these Kleenex wet wipes. I got them, I think, in a Walmart box at some point. I ran out of makeup wipes. I couldn't find my big pack my mother-in-law bought me. And I'm like, I need some. I grabbed those out and I used them up. And they're okay. I wouldn't recommend using these on your face. I don't know if you can use them on your face. It says you can. I didn't use them on my face. I used them to wipe my hands. I use makeup wipes when I'm doing my makeup because I don't like anything on my hands. Okay, and I use these also. Boy, these are dirty. You can tell I use them when I do my makeup. Look how dirty they are, covered in makeup. These are from Patchology, Clean AF, and it was a sample of wipes. I use those too. They're pretty good. I don't use makeup wipes, like I said, on my face. Very rarely do I use them on my face. I use them just to wipe my hands. So, okay. Now, from Sooae, S-O-O-A-E, this is the V-Line Chin Up Mask. Actually, I like this mask. It fits just on the bottom, just on your chin, and it comes up over your ears. Actually, I enjoyed wearing this mask. Did it firm? I don't know, but I wouldn't mind some more of these. I enjoyed that one. And then also, I used this one, and I think this was from Target. No, Bath and Body Works. This is from Bath and Body Works. This one is If You Shea So. Oh my gosh, this one, I put this one on after I had my allergic reaction to a mask I used, and this was so creamy, if I can say that. It was very moisturizing, and it felt so good on my face. I have never had a chic mask feel as good as this one. That's feel fantastic. This was so nice. So I'm very pleased with the sheet mask. Usually I can't tell anything from sheet masks. I can from the, I like these two. All right. I used up my e.l.f. Illuminating Mist and Set. I use these less expensive face setting mists to dampen my sponges to do my makeup, because I like to use a setting mist, a face spray, to dampen my sponge. And I use the sponge to usually blend out my concealer and to set under my eyes with my powder. And so I like to use less expensive ones. I would buy this again, and probably will. I probably will buy that one again. I have some Wet n Wilds I need to use up, and then I'll probably go back to e.l.f. That was nice. These two, the Briogeo. These are the Kale and Apple Shampoo and Conditioner. I bought these, $16, just to let you know, they're expensive. I like them so much, I bought the huge ones. I bought the big ones because I like them so much. I don't know that I will buy them again. I'm not saying I won't. I just don't know yet, but I like these. I like these a lot. I don't think I'd pay $16 for these little ones again. But if you've never used it and you want to try it, then I said, you know, I got about, I don't know, 4 or 5 washes out of this, I think. It's a lot, but it's good. I have a couple of scent birds in here. I got the Lalique, and I've got the Michael Kors Wonderlust. They were in my sample stash, and I used them up. Let's see what else I have. I have a concealer in here. It's the Urban Decay All Nighter. This was in my project pan. I used this all up. You know what? This is not a bad concealer. I would probably purchase this again, but I like to buy new things. You guys, I think you know. I like to try new things. I'm always looking for the next best thing. So I probably won't purchase this again, but I really enjoyed it and I did like it. And if it's on sale, I might purchase it. I probably would purchase it if it's on sale, and I would recommend it. My color, by the way, was light neutral was my color. I used up this sample of Laura Geller, hello speak, Sparkle Treatment. It's a makeup primer. I really like this. This one I really liked. I have a ton of primers. Somehow I have got a huge stash of primers in my collection, full sizes. And so I don't foresee me buying a primer for a long time. But I would purchase this one. I really would. I liked it. I liked it that much. This Diva Curl High Shine Multi Benefit Oil. This was in one of my Sample Stash Mondays. And I liked it. And then I set it aside and then just didn't use it again for a while. Picked it up, used it, fell in love with it after I got my hair cut. Fell in love with this, and this started me on the Diva Curl. And so this is the High Shine Multi Benefit Oil. Oh yes, I probably will purchase this. And these Diva Curl products smell good, and they all don't smell the same. They have different scents, But they all smell really good. So, yeah. Enjoyed that. And then last, I threw in my Too Faced Better Than Sex Mascara. This one is the purple one from the Nikki Tutorials set I purchased, oh my gosh, a couple years ago? I'm not sure. I think it's a couple years ago. The one that everybody's talking about, the Nikki Tutorials collab with Too Faced, and it came with a purple mascara. I had this in my drawer. I used this maybe 3-4 times, but it's old, and it probably could be used again, but, you know, my eyes, I'm so picky with my eyes, I'm not going to use it, so I just threw it away in the trash. So, that's all of my empties. Pretty good. Bunch of empties here, I think. I see an afternoon of cleaning out candle jars, although I am only planning on keeping this one. The others I will put in recycled. They can be recycled. But, yeah. That's it. So I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. If you're new to my channel, I would love it if you would subscribe. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down below. I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.